it's the Inevitable, a performance SUV from Hyundai's burgeoning N brand. After nearly 4 years with just one model in Europe, the superb i30N hot hatch, the South Korean brand's feisty performance offshoot, has added another two almost at once. Just as the i20N hot hatch has gone on sale, a healthy waiting list soon following, we now have this, the Kona N. Not only is it inevitable, though, it's actually kinda welcome. While the small crossover crowd is a largely uninspiring place for a car enthusiast to shop, the stock Kona stood out at launch. Not only for its stark, amphibious front end, but for driving uncommonly tidily for its class. Albert Biemann was snared from BMW's M division not only to make the i30N and follow-up NS fun to drive, but to make the rest of the Hyundai and Kia conglomerate's cars handle with a base level of competency. Which is precisely what the Kona did, especially in its wholly convincing electric form. But there's little semblance of saving the world distilled into this, a car that may be the last end product launched with internal combustion as its sole power source. All hints are that N will soon be electric, potentially making this near 300 bhp chonk something of an unexpected send-off. It all looks good on paper. The powertrain from the Hyundai i30N is squeezed into the slightly smaller, though 50 kg heavier, Kona, which means it stays front-wheel drive. That helps keep weight acceptable at 1.5 tons. A 2.0-litre 4CYL turbo petrol engine provides 276 brake horsepower and 289 pounds-feet, yielding a 0-62 mph time of 5.5 seconds and a 149 mph top speed. If you're buying into the SUV world for a pretense of off-roading nous, then supplementary to an N-honed stability control setup is a dial of sand, snow and hill descent modes which you'll almost certainly never use. It sits beside the selector of your only gearbox option, an 8-speed twin-clutch paddle shifter with launch control and a multitude of extra modes, all with silly names like N-Grin Shift, to help spice up the fact there's no manual option. Nope. Ignore the tinsel and this is a genuinely great twin-clutch transmission, one that's evidently been developed by car nerds before having its functions named by marketeers. It shifts quickly and smartly and is probably more impressive left to its own devices than when you start tugging at the paddles yourself. Leave things alone and you've a better chance of eking out fuel economy, infamously an N-Division weak point thus far. Hyundai claims 194 g/km of CO2 and 33.2 miles per gallon, expect the latter to fall into the mid-20s the moment you get excitable. The performance SUV may be a modern phenomenon, titchier ones like this, especially, but plenty about the Kona is old school. Turning the escape off really does turn it off and there's a traditional manual handbrake. And Hyundai has done a proper engineering job on it rather than just pump up the wheel size and drop the suspension, it actually rides no lower than a regular Kona but boasts additional weld points on its bodyshell and a limited slip differential as standard. Oh, and it completed 489 development laps, equating to 6,308 miles, of you know where to properly earn that N on the back. It's a proper job. While we can expect future N-Division cars to be electric, and perhaps hydrogen-powered, it's currently providing an antidote to swelling technology by making rapscallion little cars like this, cars that draw their driver into mischief with little persuasion. Just with all of the active safety tech a family SUV needs, a simple button press away. It's joyously silly. And if you can cope with mildly insatiable thirst and a firm ride, it ought to be more than capable of handling everyday life too. Most fun small performance crossover on sale may sound like faint praise, but it's a title true of the Kona N either way. In essence, this is an i30N hot hatch that's had its wheelbase shortened and its center of gravity nudged up. And it drives just as the recipe suggests, an already roguish character is now even more cartoonish. The DCT gearbox is a sophisticated item, and with 8 nicely stacked ratios, you can potter along quietly and cruise at 2000 PM should you wish. But the powertrain is always gagging to really let loose, and this is a car that falls easily out of its shackles as soon as you start stiffening its suspension or loosening its stability control. There's a mobile rear end should you lift off the throttle or brake exuberantly into a turn, it's a right old laugh without ever giving you the scares. It's like a boisterous little puppy scurrying across the lino into the kitchen, with no malice to its excitement whatsoever. If this all sounds like an irrelevance, then consider that its innate sense of humor really shows up the studious side of its mostly VW Group rivals. Only a Ford Puma ST feels anything like as daft as this, and it's down by nearly 80 brake horsepower. Correct. This is mercilessly stiff, as has been the N-Division way thus far. The suspension has three settings, but normal feels like where the middling Sport ought to be, while Sport Plus is something you'll try once and never revisit, we suspect. There's much, much customization possible within its numerous driving modes, but it's all relatively intuitive and you can corral two favored setups to access with a quick steering wheel button prod, a prod which the Kona NS digital dials actually prompt you to do when the car's forward-facing camera spots a bendy road sign. Told you it was daft. You'll want the limited slip differential in its sportier setting if you're to avoid torque steer. The gearbox has four different levels of ferocity. Left in drive in its second most sporty mode, you might never need to pull a single paddle, so good is it at changing down into corners and up out of them. A late, impromptu manual down change is always instant and accompanied with a naughty growl of assertive rev matching, though, and will make you smile almost as much as if you'd done it with a traditional manual box.